everyone, welcome back to Naomi's Bookshelf. I am going to do the Dilemmas of a Book Nerd tag today. I was tagged by Lauren Reed's Pages. Thank you for tagging me. I have yet to do this tag. I felt like I was the last person on earth that hadn't done this tag, so I'm glad to do it. It'll be an interesting one though, because I definitely haven't done enough reading in my mind to do a mid-month wrap-up, so that's why this video is coming out in the middle of the month and not a mid-month wrap-up. But we're just gonna see how it goes. So let's just jump straight into the questions. The questions were created by Lindsay's Little Library, and I will link both her and Lauren down below. So question one is book storage. How do you store your books? I don't. These are my shelves. I am tweaking my sections since I just moved, but I definitely just fill my shelves with books. I don't really store them. I only keep books that I have loved or I really want to reread at some point or that hold some sort of sentimental value. Otherwise, only books that I am really interested in. So there's really nothing to store because I really want everything at easy access. The next question is, how do you track your books? I usually use Goodreads. That is my main source of tracking. I like to keep track of how many pages I read per year, how many books, setting my yearly goal and things like that. But I also took up bullet journaling last year and I have really enjoyed it. So part of my bullet journaling process is I track how many pages I read per day. It helps me can see if I have any low days or high days or what kind of happened. Another thing I like to track in here is my amount of books that I read, the genres, where I got them from, these kind of items. So that's how I track my reading, but most of the time it was on Goodreads. I have since I picked up bullet journaling in January of last year, I have really enjoyed this experience of tracking my books. So the next question is borrow. Do you lend out books? And absolutely. I find that if I keep a book on my shelf and it's not being read, I feel like it's really just wasting space unless there's someone who wants to read it. I have no problem sharing books. I will share books with basically anyone. As long as you return a book, you will get another book from me. And I really feel like that's something where I don't want to hold on to it with too tight of hands, but I understand why so many people do. It's just my thing to, I want to share the love and share the books. So the next question is, how do you acquire books or buy books? I buy typically from used bookstores. I do like to support authors and publishers by buying directly from the brand new bookstores, buying a bit more expensive if I really like that or like those authors or those books ideas. I really don't mind spending the extra money to support those authors and support those publishers, as well as supporting local. I also really use my library. I acquire a lot of books through the library, and I definitely enjoy that resource in my life. The next question is about the comments you get. So I don't really get too many of these, but I felt like sometimes I do as well, where how do you read so much in a month? How did you get that many books done? And honestly, I am a reader in waves. I fully acknowledge that the first two weeks of typical month, I am not a much of a reader. And then the last 2 weeks, I can bang out 10 books. I don't know how it works, but it just does. I often I'll take a lull almost. I need a 2 week vacation from reading so many books, but then I read so much because I'm stressed that I didn't read enough. And it's just something I've always done. I can read a bunch in a row. I can read four in a weekend. I think I read 5 in one weekend last month, but that's not normal when I am in a lull for a week and a half, 2 weeks, then I'm taking it slow. So it just really comes in waves for me. And I just, when I'm feeling the mood to read, I do. And when I don't, I don't. And I just try to enjoy my time as best I can and not forcing reading into that picture if I'm not feeling like it. The next dilemma is next book. How do you pick which book to read next? And for me, this is really something where I like to set into my TBRs. I really do enjoy a TBR. I feel like it pushes me to read throughout the month as I know that there's a list of books that I wanted to get to. But then also, I don't like to read the same genre for too long, so I like to really mix it up. I like to throw in children's books. I like to throw in mysteries or thrillers or classics. This month, for example, I am reading a couple historical romances. I'm reading Harry Potter. I am reading a couple classics. I'm just reading all over the board. And it's just something where if I feel in the mood to pick up a certain book, I can. So I'll read a book and then I'll just be like, you know what? I'm really feeling like I need some easy, sappy, in a good way, historical romance, then I'll just pick up that and it's already on my TBR. So that's kind of how I do it. I mood read through my TBR, and I like my TBRs to be diverse enough that I can do that and not feel stuck or bored or make myself feel rebellious. So the next question is travel. How do you pick which books to bring with you on your trips? I try to use ebooks, to be honest. Ebooks, audiobooks, I just find that that's more accessible, so I can bring more books with me. I do own a Kindle, but I tend to just use my iPad tablet, my iPad mini, to just like read books on that, as I do have the app on there. I also try to bring smaller books, paper bags, and sometimes it's just books off my TBR that I'm like, I really, really want to read this, and I don't mind carrying it in my suitcase and taking up space. So that's kind of my method of approach. I just definitely like to see what I'm interested in and then maybe predict what I'm going to feel like at that time. The next question is annotate. Do you mark up your books, write in them, highlight whatever? And I wish I did. I am so scared of failure that I am terrified to do it though. I really want to. I've been wanting to for a couple years now. And it's just something where I'm scared to do it. I feel like in a lot of areas of my life, I tend to be very scared to try something new. So when it came to even starting a BookTube channel, I waited a year to do it because I was just scared of failure. So annotating books is something else that I'm like really scared to do, but I really want to do. And I found this copy of Rebecca. It's like a $2 copy, and in it, someone colored in it. I'm sure a child was very naughty and colored in their parents' book. So I really would like to read Rebecca. I have listened to a radio drama of it before, so I do know the story, but I haven't read the book. So I would like to really read this and to get myself engrossed in it and annotate my banged up copy. So I don't feel so scared to do it, but I just haven't found the time to read Rebecca. So if you're watching this and you want to read Rebecca, let me know, or reread Rebecca, let me know. I would love to buddy read this and I can like get annotating and try it out for the first time. The next question is backlist or new? And so for me, I really love my backlist books. That's part of being a classics reader, is loving backlist. I really enjoy reading backlist from other authors, things that have been published 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 2 years ago. I really enjoy that. But at the same time, I really enjoy new releases. So I do like both, and I'm trying to balance them. I also, since I joined NetGalley, I've been reading a few more new releases. I'm trying not to go too crazy on NetGalley because I don't want to be overwhelmed with the amount of ARCs that I have yet to read or I need to get to. So I'm trying to take it easy on that, but those are new releases that I have been reading and enjoying for the most part. So it's just one of those things where life needs a balance, and this is my balance. I do enjoy both. I tend to read more backlist, but I do really enjoy new releases as well. So the last dilemma is sequels. Do you read them as they come out, or do you read them, or do you wait till they're all out to read the series? Now, I am not a series reader. I definitely don't read a lot of series. Most of my books I pick are standalones to read. I don't mind waiting for the sequel because typically the series I enjoy focus on one character for one book, and then the next book focuses on a different character, and then the next book focuses on a different character. So there's no massive need to follow that direct character. But as I do read series, I think about some series that I read, and like the Charles Todd books, I really enjoy their series. It's a mother-son writing pair. And I definitely read those as they come out from my library. I really love them. And I don't wait, because sometimes when a book series is like 20 books long, you just don't want to wait until the final one is published. I also have been just reading my way through the O'Hare and Fox series by Janet Ivanovich and Lee Goldberg, and I am just reading those as they come because I'm already caught up and I don't want to wait to read the next book until the next book comes out. So I don't mind reading them right away, but I also tend not to read sequels or series. So I guess an extra dilemma for me would be tagging anyone, because I feel like I said, everyone's done this tag. Now, I'm going to tag a few people who, I don't know if you've done this, I honestly haven't researched who did this or not, but if you've done it, let me know in the comments and I'll go back and watch your answers. I'll find your video. And if not, I'd love to see your answers if you'd like to do this tag. And if you have not done this tag, you are free to be tagged by me. So I'm going to tag Elizabeth Ann Reads. I'm also going to tag Berna's Bookish Adventures. And I'm also going to tag Megan Hannett and Sarah Hannett to see what your answers are on this tag. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you would like to and like this video. I put out a video twice a week on Sundays and Thursdays. So thanks for watching. I will see you all on Sunday with another video. Bye for now.